I'd like to tell you a little story. It concerns a certain Mr. Ronald Seth, a scholarly English gentleman who, in Anno Domini 1967, wrote an excellent book entitled Witches and Their Craft. When he was a little boy of 7 or 8 years old, Master Seth was taken by his stepmother to visit a friend who had recently birthed a baby. They lived in the Fens, a region of England, a remote and marshy moor, which has been associated with witchcraft since the most ancient times. As they were admiring the pretty baby in its cradle, there was suddenly a loud knocking at the door. The lady of the house went to answer it. Master Seth heard the gruff voice of a beggar demanding a few pennies. The lady said she had nothing to spare and slammed the door in the man's face. Master Seth's stepmother looked out of the window as the man went down the garden path and remarked that he looked more like a gypsy. As she was saying this, the young mother stooped over the cradle and screamed. The little baby's head and face were covered with a seething mass of tiny insects, like lice. The mother snatched up her purse and, trembling, gave little Master Seth 2 pennies, telling him to run after the stranger and give them to him. He found the vagabond in the lane, squatting by the hedge near the garden gate, waiting. He grinned and held out his hand. Changed her mind, did she? I thought she would. He pocketed the pennies. Tell her I'll take it off. The little boy ran back to the house without a word. His mother had the baby in her arms. It cooed happily. The lice had vanished, every single one. This little story doesn't really prove anything. How could it? But it's interesting, don't you think?